I am Pam Fox at pamfox.org, and in today's video, I'm going to be answering a question from Christian about exercising with a hiatal hernia. So, I have found your course very helpful with my hiatal hernia. I am a power lifter, so I am used to working out with heavy weights several times a week. I understand that I am going to have to put that aside for a while until I find myself in a state with minimal symptoms, but I don't think I can stay away from the exercising in general. Are there any sorts of exercises that you can recommend that have minimal core ab activation so I can avoid the risk of too much abdominal pressure? Okay, so when it comes to exercising with a hiatal hernia, there's a couple of different lines of thought. First of all, I think it's great that Christian is making reversing the hiatal hernia a priority and setting exercise, particularly powerlifting, on the back burner. I think that's great because when it comes to heavy lifting, that does put a tremendous amount of pressure pushing the stomach upward towards and into the diaphragm. So then the question becomes, do I have to cut out exercise altogether? And the answer is usually no. Usually most people with a hiatal hernia can find some type of exercise if they want to, that they can continue with while they reverse their hiatal hernia. But the emphasis needs to be on not necessarily the type of exercise. While that's going to be different for everybody, because depending on your hernia, you may be able to tolerate, you know, walking but not running. You may be able to tolerate running but not swimming or not biking or something. You know, just it's going to be different for everybody. And so you really just kind of have to play around with it, do trial and error, and see what you can tolerate. And you'll know what you can tolerate because if you go for a run and your symptoms are elevated during that run, if you go for a bike ride and your symptoms are elevated during that bike ride or directly after, then you know that you're probably not quite ready for that particular exercise. But even if you do something like some gentle stretching or some light walking, and that even that elevates your symptoms, I'm going to talk next about why that could be the possible reason or the probable reason as to why that is. So when we do any kind of exercise, we engage the abdominal muscles. And if you've been following me for any amount of time, you know that it's really a foundational key in my reversal protocol to train yourself how to relax your abdominal muscles, which probably goes, they're still doing construction in my building, so I apologize for all the noise. Relaxing your abdominal muscles probably goes against everything you believe and have been taught about your abs, which is to tighten them all the time, pull them in, you know, contract your abs, pull in your abs, tighten your abs, all of this type of training and thinking that a lot of us have been exposed to as long as we can remember. And so this type of thinking and training has conditioned you to always be tightening your abdominal muscles, which you shouldn't be. You shouldn't be always tightening your abdominal muscles. And when you do so, it trains them to forget how to relax. It trains them to be very tight and to lose elasticity. And it trains you to breathe in your chest instead of in your belly, which means your belly has a really hard time expanding because it can't stretch because it is so tight. And that means that you've always got a lot of pressure on your abdominal cavity. Your stomach sits right underneath your diaphragm where there's a hole known as the hiatus, and it will seek out escape through that hole if something is constantly putting pressure on it and pushing it up. And pulling in your abs is one of the biggest forms of intragastric pressure that pushes your stomach up. And so, as I was saying before, when we exercise, we very naturally engage and contract our abdominal muscles because they're just connected to everything. So whether you're walking or swimming or biking or lifting weights or whatever it is, you'll probably, if you start to pay attention, you notice those abs are contracting. And if you ask yourself right now, what are my abs doing right now? Like as you're sitting watching this video, ask yourself, can I relax my abs any more than I already am? You'll probably notice that you are pulling in your abs right now, that you were pulling them in tight and holding them tight. If you can relax them at all, that means you were holding them in tight. And so this will give you an indication of how much conditioning there is in always contracting those abdominal muscles. And for most of us, you know, if we've done a lot of, you know, exercise with an instructor, like any type of coach or trainer or instructor, they will always tell you to do what? To pull in those abs. And so you have to retrain yourself to relax those abs while you exercise. So that's the main takeaway here, and what I told Christian. Go ahead and find an exercise that you want to do. Yes, put the powerlifting on the back burner for now. Find an exercise you want to do, whether it's gentle stretching or walking or riding your bike, whatever it is. But retrain yourself how to consistently be relaxing the abs while you do that exercise. And if you try this, what you'll probably find is that your abs are really tight. You'll be like, oh yeah, Pam's right. I'm just totally sucking in my gut right now. Relax those muscles. And then if you come back to it 1 minute later, 2 minutes later, 5 minutes later, you'll notice that they're pulled in tight again because you've trained yourself. Well, one, they engage when we exercise. Those muscles engage, and that's okay. But you don't want to be pulling them in tight throughout your entire workout. You want to give those muscles a break and relax those muscles and breathe into your belly. Expand your belly as you're breathing through exercise. It's okay to contract and squeeze your abs when you need to, like when you're heavy lifting, for example, you're going to notice that. But if you can train yourself how to breathe in the belly and really expand those and stretch those abdominal muscles, what that does is it opens up the abdominal cavity and allows the stomach to move down then. Instead of always being pushed up, it'll give that room to move down. And for some people, not most people, but some people, they get relief from their hiatal hernia and reflux symptoms immediately just by practicing this one thing, by mastering the ability to relax their abs throughout the day, while they're at work, while they exercise, while they're driving their car, while they're washing the dishes. Relaxing the abs, practicing that, mastering that, and they start to notice less and less symptoms because they were just squeezing their abs tight all the time. And usually this is for people with a very, very small hiatal hernia. This is usually, I'm talking about people who get like really quick, instant relief. They are the minority. They are the minority. I just don't want to get people's hopes up that you're just going to start relaxing your abs and everything's going to be all better. Because if you have other underlying conditions, you need to heal your gut. You've got a very large hiatal hernia. It's been up and lodged in that position for a very long time. Or you have other types of hiatal hernias that are a little bit harder to reverse. It's going to take more than just relaxing your abs in order to reverse it. But if you're in the process of reversing your abdominal muscles, or you're in the process of reversing your hiatal hernia, and you want to reincorporate exercise or begin exercise or start exercising again, it's okay. Just try it out. Start out with something easy, like walking or biking, something, you know, fairly low impact that isn't going to require anything, you know, heavy lifting. And really make the emphasis, the focus on your abdominal muscles and just letting those go. That means you're going to wear loose clothing. You're not going to put on a pair of Spanx and then a pair of leggings, you know, over the top of that, holding everything in tight. Put on a pair of nice shorts with a loose elastic band and a loose t-shirt, so you can just really release and let your gut go, relax those muscles, and allow that stomach to start to hang down and pull down and stretch that back out again, breathing into the belly. And I'll warn you now, this is not easy at first if you've come from a lifetime of training yourself to suck in your gut, okay? Those muscles are tight, they've forgotten how to relax, they're unable to stretch, they've lost elasticity, and so expanding the belly and breathing into the belly will take time and practice, but it's so worth it. If you can really train yourself how to breathe in and expand that belly, remember that when we take in a breath, the diaphragm presses down. Right? It presses down, and if it's met with those abs pulling in, you've got the diaphragm pressing down and the abs pulling in, which means high pressure in the abdominal cavity. What happens under high pressure? That stomach is going to seek that escape through that hole that sits right above it, okay? Which is what a hiatal hernia is. So you can reduce that intragastric pressure greatly by simply relaxing the abs. It's something that takes time and practice, but it's probably one of the easiest things you can do to help reverse your hiatal hernia. Again, depending on who you are and your situation, there may be other things that you need to do as well. You know, if you have chronic bloating and cramping and diarrhea and you know, things like this, you've probably got, you know, your digestive tract is probably in disrepair and you need to focus on healing your gut as well. So that you don't have bloating and cramping, because that's going to, you know, support that elevation of the stomach as well. So you've got to address those things. But so I hope that clears up any confusion for those of you reversing your hiatal hernia that think you can't exercise at all. You can, but the emphasis needs to be on relaxing the abs while you exercise and also stretching your abs. So take a second. You should be taking a second to stretch anyway, right? To stretch everything, but don't neglect stretching your abs. How do we stretch our abs? Well, one really easy way is to, you can lie down on your back to do this, but you can do it, I'll just show you right now, sitting here in this chair. It's really just about taking in a deep breath and expanding the belly, because that's going to stretch your abs outward, right? So you take in a deep breath and you really just expand your belly. You can kind of, I'll stand up just to help clarify that. You can kind of stick your belly out as you breathe in, so these muscles really expand and kind of blow up like a balloon, and then hold that. Just really stretch and hold that, and then relax, and then breathe in and expand. Really like blow up your belly like a balloon and expand that belly like it's, you know, blowing up like a balloon, because as it expands and blows up like this, those muscles are going to have to open up and stretch outward. And that's how you stretch your abdominal muscles. It's as simple as that. So take time to do that as part of your workout as well. And do it, you know, if you're in the gym, do it multiple times. Try to do it 2 or 3 times throughout your workout, like space it out during your workout, because I guarantee you, you can walk into the gym and go, okay, my abs are nice and relaxed, let's go to work. And 2 minutes, 5 minutes later, they're gonna be pulled, maybe even 20 seconds later, they're gonna be pulled in tight again. So you have to really focus on this, really focus on it and make it a priority of relaxing those abs while you exercise. And the more you do this, the more you'll make that connection and you'll be like, Pam was right, I'm getting it now. I'm making that connection. My abs are always tightening up. I notice it now, whereas I didn't notice it before. And now I'm getting better at being able to relax those abs so my stomach can then move downward. Okay? So just one last thing. I do have, I'm gonna link my hiatal hernia quiz in the learn more button below when I'm done uploading this video. And that's going to take you to my quiz that lists all of the different symptoms, kind of textbook symptoms, and then fringe symptoms for hiatal hernia. If you just go to any conventional website and you know, Google, you know, symptoms for hiatal hernia, it may just list like 5 or 6 symptoms, but there's really a very long list of symptoms for hiatal hernia. So this quiz will give you a better indication and give you some clarity as to whether or not you have a hiatal hernia in case you haven't been diagnosed. But just know the only way you can truly know if you have a hiatal hernia is through diagnostic testing with an image that shows, yes, you have a hiatal hernia. But I know that a lot of people don't want to go through the trouble and risk of having those diagnostic tests. You can take my quiz and get a better understanding and clarification as to whether maybe not you do have them. They are extremely common, so the chances are that if you have some of these symptoms that you probably do have a hiatal hernia. You can start doing my protocol, which is gentle and natural, and if you start to get, you know, relief from your symptoms, then that also will give you clarification that you indeed have a hiatal hernia, because if you're doing my reversal protocol, that means you're reversing your hiatal hernia, and that's why you're getting relief from your symptoms. So, and why do we want to reverse a hiatal hernia? Well, there are lots of reasons, but just getting down, I mean, just in general, it's so that you can alleviate and rid yourself of the symptoms that the hiatal hernia creates. And it's also reversing your hiatal hernia is going to reduce your risk, right, of conditions that are more serious, that are, you know, possibly potentially down the road that a hiatal hernia puts you at risk for. So having a hiatal hernia is a serious thing. It's not something you should just, you know, there are people who have kind of what they call, you know, a hiatal hernia that's dormant and it doesn't cause any issues, and that's great. And you're probably not, if you're watching this video, that's probably not you, because if you're not having symptoms, then you're not concerned about it. And those people do exist. And usually that's because, you know, they're in fairly good health and they don't have a lot of inflammation internally that's causing a lot of irritation and flare up that can create the symptoms that a hiatal hernia can create. So it is a serious thing. It should be taken seriously. And I'm living proof that you can reverse a hiatal hernia naturally. I've been helping people do it every day. So if you want to find out more about me, you can go and check out me at my website, pamfox.org, and just check the About Me tab if you want to learn more about me. And then, of course, all of my courses and then information about working with me is there at my website, pamfox.org. But the link below is going to be to my hiatal hernia quiz, if you're interested in that. All right. I hope you have a wonderful day, and thank you so much for watching.